Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today, continuing with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps. With MLflow, I will talk about deployment, the deployment server. What is the deployment server in MLflow? Well, it's a tool to use and manage different LLM providers and give you a common interface to you work with all these models. It can be commercial models or non-commercial models, and the only thing that you have a central point where you can again deploy, sorry, use and manage all the models that you want to interact with. It's a concept similar to what other providers has, like LangChain. LangSerf, if you are following the channel and you probably watch this video, is the concept is exactly the same. This MLflow is just setting a from in front of all the models, again, commercial, non-commercial, logged in the tracking server or not logged, and allow to the user interact with them. Also provide a central point of the security management central point where you can keep all the access keys to this endpoint. You probably know if you are working with OpenAI, Anthropic or Cohere or Vertex AI or Beckrot models, you need a key to access to these models, Gemini as well, whatever you access via SaaS, you need a API key to interact with these commercial products and Mistral as well, for example, and you just simply send a request to the entry point with a format, usually it's a JSON file, and you receive an answer. You can interact with these models via the API that they have. And then what the deployment server is doing for with these providers is just taking your query and send the query that the user in outside is doing back to the provider and receive the request from the provider, from the model that you are interacting with, and forward it to the user. So you will see the is pretty similar. When interacting with any of these providers is practically you will see now when working with OpenAI or working with others is exactly the same that interacting with directly with OpenAI. But the advantage, as I said, you can provide the service to the final user and you don't need to share with them the keys, and then you can design a front complex, more complex than what you are going to see here in the demonstration, where you just set up who can access to what, to which models, or and also again you don't need to share keys with anybody. You just centralize in a single point all these keys and simply provide the service via a tailored front to the final user. So I have prepared an output as usual. Later on I will post it to the repository, and I will put a link on the description of the video in order to you get access to it, and you will be able to replicate it in your environment. To install the deployment server, you can just simply install MLflow brackets GenAI. You can install all, and you will install all the tools that come together with MLflow, which is probably easier, and that's it. It's the only thing that you need. You don't need to install anything more. Well, everything that the deployment server needs to run is installed minimally with this. If you are working now in a separate environment, for this I create a new environment, I install just this, and that's it. You don't need to do anything more. We here you get the server and also the Python client to you be able to interact with the server. What do you need to run the server? Well, first of all, install and then on create a YAML file with all the configurations of your endpoints. Here I will provide you with a file with 5 endpoints. We have completion, chance, chat entry points, and embeddings. As you can see here, all the entry points have a similar format. So you just get a name, in this case it's completions, it's type LLN / version 1 / completion. The model is the provider, the name of the model, and the configuration. This is the key or the OpenAI SDK, and then you have some parameters. Here we have the chat, also with GPT 3.5 Turbo, the chat with the OpenAI. Take a look at the entry point, or the name is changing, the embeddings with the ADA 002, and also I create an additional entry point for Anthropic model chat, and we are going to interact with Claude 2.1. So also before start the server, you need to create in your environment some variables. Here main very important for those providers that need a key, you will need to store in memory the key with this command. This is for Unix. If you are working in Windows, use the environmental variables wizard to set up the environments. So you need these two are keys. MLflow deployment config is the file, the YAML file, where it's located, as you can see here, exactly the same that you will write down in the parameter. You have to assign it to this environment variable. And MLflow deployment target is simply the URL where the host is listening for to receive the request. Once you have this setup, your YAML file, your environment, and your environment variables, you can start the server with MLflow deployments, start server, hyper config path, the path to the YAML file, hyper port. This is the port where the server is listening. The host is the, here is 0.0.0.0 is all IP address of the host, and number of workers. Here I also running in the background in order to liberate the cell. In command line, you can just simply do a help, and essentially you can interact as well with the server, and well, even refresh it online. You don't need to stop it, and you can refresh the endpoints using the command line. And also you can do it programmatically, as you will see here, using the Python client. Once you start the server, you can access to the documentation. Under the hood, the deployment server, as LAN server, as the other versions that you had, like Llama Index, they had a similar technology, similar approach. You can take a look to the server, you can compare, you will see that it's really, really similar what they are doing. And then this is generated under the hood, as I said, is working, is running Fast API, and to create the application server and Pydantic, the typing enforcement library of Python. And this is automatically generated just from your YAML file. It's generating all this stuff for you, and you can check here if your endpoints are working. It's quite convenient stuff, especially to test the endpoints, what do you need to interact with the endpoints, and so on and so forth. Really, really useful for those that have to work in operations. This is a treasure. fantastic that this is automatically generated, because to do this, just to document all the endpoints, you can spend easily 2 days just in documenting all this stuff. And this is again automatically done by Pydantic and Fast API. Watch the video, you will see that the LandServe is doing exactly the same. And again, you watch it 2 months ago or 3 months ago when I recorded, I say exactly the same for them. Okay, so here you can take a look to the different endpoints. We had 5, as we had on our YAML file. Let's take a look. I have it here as well. I will patch you later the YAML file as well in the repo. So we have 5. And then on again, this is what we simply pass to the server. You check here /d/repos/mlserve and my file config.yaml. This is the file I'm using to run the server. Okay, now let's go to interact with the serve. So you just import from deployments the getconfig client. Here I'm going to set up my tracking server as the local host. As you remember, you probably watched this in some previous videos on the channel. This is my local infrastructure of Emerflow deployed in Dockers with the tracking server, the PHP my admin to the admin tool to manage my MySQL MariaDB database, where I log in all the metadata of my experiments. So you can do this as well with Databricks. We will need to define some other tracking URI, and well, this is already discussed on the channel, so you can take a look to the previous videos, and you can set up wherever you want, either to localhost, to the file system, or to Databricks or the Docker's infrastructure, as I had. All of them, all those videos are on the channel in this playlist, so you can take a look and decide what you want. So you get the deployment client, so the server is listening in the port 5888. So we just get the client, we just can interrogate the client, and you can see here our entry points. Now we are going to interact with the different endpoints. Here with the chat is GPT 3.5 Turbo, OpenAI. You just send a message, and well, you can see here, if you are familiar with the OpenAI interface, this is exactly what OpenAI responds. Essentially, the deployment server is taking your request, forwarding the request to the OpenAI API, and the OpenAI API answer, and this answer is forwarded back to you. Here, the same with Anthropic. And again, you can check here, it's exactly the same what you get from Anthropic, and obviously another ID, chat completion, model Claude 2.1, etc. Predict with chat GPT-4, and now instruction or completions with GPT 3.5 Turbo. Here we are going to do another example. Here we are going to use a Emerflow model. The Emerflow model is just a wrapper for a land chain where it's interacting with the endpoint completions. Completions in this case is ChatGPT 3.5 Turbo. in the mode completion. It's an instruction model. So we send a prompt. Here we create a template prompt. The template prompt has an adjective. Listen instead to. I don't have the. We can set to the. Okay, it's fine. We are sending this to GPT 3.5 Turbo. We send a template. This template adjective job adjective. Yes, we run or invoke. Invoke better because the run is going to be deprecated. So we run the chain. We print the result. Here we are logging the model. I will show you this. You will be very, very happy to see this. And here we just load the model with pyfun, and we do the same prediction. Here adjective fun is sad or very sad. Let's check very sad. So here. It was too tired. Okay, so we can send some, probably some. Why couldn't stand by itself? Because it was too tired. That is not very funny, but okay. So what we did here? Well, we just log a model in the experiment. You can check here. The experiment is MLSERF. So you go here to the experiment and you can see here we lock the server, we lock the model, it's a land chain flavor, and we log it with pyfun, the Python model, and well, you have here the model which is interacting with our entry point, with an entry point. And yeah, you have simply, you can deploy this model now everywhere. You just need to have these dependencies installed in the environment where you want to work, and that's it. And you can interact now with this chain, land chain, in any place. So you look at the channel, look at the channel, and you will see that we have different videos where we are interacting with different technologies, different flavors, and also with the common one. The common one is the PY model. The PY model is the library, the class that you can use to log and interact with any technology, even with your own custom models. So it's a wrapper. And then it's defining an interface to lock the models in MLflow and load the models from the MLflow registry, from the model registry, and then on use it for inference. And so it's exactly the same that we did here. And finally, well, just if you want to set programmatically and use where you had the deployment server, you just use the method deployment target or and get target to get the URL of your deployment server. The final is this. You can interact as well with the API using the similar URL, just getting the endpoints here. So you can take a look to the documentation that you have here to see how the, you see here the endpoints, and later you can interact with these point limits, and that's it. Okay. That's all. As you see, this is quite interesting stuff. I think that we should keep an eye on this. It's still, let me show you the models that are already working under this interface. You can use OpenAI, Mosaic, Anthropic, Cohere, Azure OpenAI, Palm, MLflow, Hugging Face. So MLflow is everything that you had in MLflow, that you are using in MLflow, you can use it through this interface. And simple than that. Moving Phase, Arbeck, Roth, Mistral, and Together AI. So you had Offer, Completion, Chats, and Embeddings. Strange that here we still don't have Cloud 3, and also in here Bethrot, only Titan, and Palm from Ambison from Google. Well, since to me that they don't have the documentation completely documented, or they are not they are still working. By the way, the deployment server is still experimental, so be careful. You plan to use it in production. But in any case, I think like many other things that are still as well in experience, all the stuff in LLM stuff is still in experimental mode. Again, the complexity of the working with LLMs, I guess, is the reason that is taking a little bit longer than expecting. But at the end, like other providers are doing, like LangChain or Llama Index, it will be soon available and working as a production functionality in Everflow. So keep an eye, and you can hear some tutorials. I didn't see them. I just followed this one to complete the video. And read the documentation. You will see that is something that can be very, very useful and allow us again to provide the user a common interface for all the LLMs that we have in the company, and also centralize all the keys and access material to this, especially the commercial models. And you can keep control of who is accessing to what, which is in some cases very important too, as well. Manage costs and manage and control what the users can do or cannot do with the LLMs, which today is essentially something that is becoming critical. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I will now upload the material to the repository, and I will point you out in the description of the video to this to where you can find it. And again, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you find this interesting and useful for your job and or training. And as I said, usually, give me a like if you like it, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your friends and colleagues if you think it's interesting also for them, and that way you help me to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you, see you soon.